Today we're going to talk about the Buehler AbrasiMet XL Pro Heavy Duty Abrasive Cutter. This is a large abrasive cutter designed for high volume applications. A few of the design features to talk about here: 13 horsepower motor, blade sizes ranging from 14 to 18 inch size. We have a very easy to use interface here for control of the machine. A few of the design features we built into this machine in order to allow ease of use and convenience here, you can see is a very well lit cutting chamber. It's about 3 feet by 2 feet inside. Good visibility from the front and both sides. We've got under the vice table, a lot of room under here in order to make cleaning very easily. Stainless steel components throughout. No lost parts under the vice table after cutting. We've got coolant here. Very easy to position coolant exactly where you want it, either on the blade or on the part. We've got a quick change blade system on here in order to change the blade. A quick lock nut here. Simply rotate the nut. You can take the nut off without any tools. Remove the flange. Take your blade off. Install your next blade. Put your flange on. And tighten your nut by hand. Again, no tools. The nut will self-tighten during cutting. Very easy, very fast blade changes. Heavy duty, robust cutter for your most challenging cutting applications. This is a three-axis machine. You can move the blade in the X direction and serial cut in any location you want along the X. The blade also moves in the Z direction in a typical chop cutting type application. The vice table also moves in the Y, in both the positive and negative Y. So you can put a large part in here and cut in the Y direction if you choose. You can cut in the Z direction. And you can program the machine automatically to set up to make multiple cuts in various locations along the X-axis. So the user can program this to make an extended cut without need of attendance of the user. You can cut the machine, set up the machine to cut and literally walk away. This is the control panel for the AbrasiMet XL abrasive cutter. Very intuitive, easy to use touch panel here. Setting up all of the controls for a given cut that you want. Some cut options in here. You can select your cut option very easily. This would be for cutting in the Z direction. This would be a typical chop type cut. You can set a Y cut where the vice bed advances toward the blade and cuts in a Y direction. There's also a plane cut. Plane cut is a form of minimum area of contact cutting where you can limit the amount of material in contact with the blade at any given time. Reduces the potential for thermal damage. Makes cutting very difficult to cut materials possible that otherwise might not be. We also have a manual mode the user can select if they choose to operate the saw manually using the joystick. Below the cut options, you see some of the other features built into this saw. Cut start detect allows the user to advance the blade at a higher rate of speed than the set feed rate prior to the cut. This avoids the delay in waiting for the blade to advance to the sample to begin your cut. So it speeds up your cutting time quite a bit with cut start detect, allows the blade to advance right up to the cut, begin cutting at the feed rate, and then return to its original position. Pulse cut is a feature commonly found on Buehler saws. Pulse cut momentarily stops the advance of the blade during the cut in order to allow coolant to cool the sample and limit thermal damage to very difficult to cut materials. Our variable SmartCut is a new feature for this saw. SmartCut limits the power available for a given cut. You can set up variable SmartCut to various levels of power depending on what it is that you're cutting. SmartCut really allows the user to automate the setting of feed rate, especially for samples that have variable geometry where feed rate would vary considerably. In areas of the part where cutting is more difficult, you have more material to cut through, you can automatically have the machine slow down in those areas and automatically increase the feed rate in more easy to cut areas depending on your application needs. I return to the home screen, you'll see some of the other features on here. These are simply options to be able to set your feed depth, your feed rate, and your cut depth very easily. Here we've got a feature called Table Protect on this saw. This allows the user to set up a specified distance the saw is able to advance before the machine will stop the advance of the blade. This prevents damage to the table. The blade won't cut through parts that you don't want to cut through. Very easy for the user to set this for any given cut or any given shift to prevent damage to the machine. This machine also has serial cutting capability. This allows the user to pre-program a series of cuts in either the positive or negative X direction. These cuts can be entered into a program and saved for recall later in the event that type of cut is used repetitively. One can either program a series of equal cuts of the same thickness across a part, or simply move the saw along the axis and use the laser to align to select areas where you wish to cut and save that program to make those cuts later. Now we'd like to show you some cutting with the AbrasiMet XL Pro cutter. Here I've got a common drivetrain component to cut, and we're going to cut it in this direction this way to show you how variable SmartCut works. As we cut through a part like this, we've got a great deal of kerf area, a lot of contact area with the blade as we begin, and SmartCut will slow down the cutting through this area. After we cut through this, we've got much less contact area down in this area of the part, so SmartCut will be able to speed up the cutting for the shortest cut time and ensure burn-free cutting throughout the entire part. Take a look at the part I've got set up in the saw right here, and we'll start the machine. You can see SmartCut is activated, reducing the feed rate at the initial stages of the cut, allowing the feed rate to accelerate as the cut proceeds. This allows you to get the fastest cut time while still ensuring burn-free cutting. It takes the guesswork out of setting the feed rate for parts of varying geometry or parts of unknown hardness. We have our cut component. You can see very clean, burn-free cut throughout. Here we have the machine set up to serial section a drivetrain component. We're going to make multiple cuts in this sample in one program method using serial cutting. So the machine's going to come along and cut in each of the marked areas on the sample. In order to set up a serial cut, we're going to go to the control panel and we're going to select serial cut. And everywhere we want to make a cut, we're going to move the blade to the location we want to cut, and we're going to press Add Cut. So as we move the blade, you're going to see the laser align with the cut region. At that location, we're going to press Add Cut. We'll then move over to the next location for cut on the bar. Press Add Cut here, move to the next location, and add our final cut here. When we're done with this, we're going to press Home. It's going to bring the blade back to the start position, ready to make this cut. If this is a cut that's commonly done, this program can be saved in the machine and recalled and used at the press of a button anytime later. Thank you. samples, clean cut, burn free, shortest cut time.